Disgusting.
He will, however, lift his shirt for you.
Absolutely.
Why did you even bring that up?
John, do you want to sit or are you going to stand today?
Oh,
no,
wow.
I'm sitting.
You know, you'll be warmer if you stand.
I'm not going to stand.
Can we name the possum Paul Dixon? I don't think Paul would appreciate that,
what
DP.
Possum?
You missed my whole, you want to see possum?
Okay.
I didn't think so. Whoops. Wow, I did not dress myself very well today. I did not put on appropriate shoes for the outfit. Hey, Christopher.
Hello.
I never saw, was it Christopher Withers? And if you're saying you're from the UK, I'm assuming so.
Oh, are we going to,
thank you, Scam
Mankey. Do any QNAP spots?
Yeah, we should.
Okay, let me go make a lower third. We're just doing QNAP.com, right? We don't have a...
Correct.
Okay.
Hubert, are you Hubert? Is that... Don't touch... I was going to surprise you with that.
I knew it was coming.
It's always peeking in the packages. Are you sick,
no
Hubert? I don't think he's ever told us how to say his name. Is it Hubert or Hubert? Because there's an I in there.
Hubert.
But is it Hubert?
Hubert.
It is
I
now.
Feel like it's wrong.
John, scoot in just a hair. Okay, thanks.
Oh, where's my puppy?
Behind you.
Oh, he is. Okay. Thank you.
So the puppy's there and the
Pablo's,
cat's gone?
Yeah.
Where's the cat?
It's over
the cat's
there.
In the cradle.
Creepy kitty's
oh,
over
I
there.
Oh, I see.
Yes, Jenny, I'm warm finally. And John was freezing. That's a nice shirt.
Thank
Gorgeous.
You.
It's like got this little pattern that's...
It does. It's a Tommy
going
Bahama.
On there. Oh.
It's soft, too.
Nice.
Yeah. Tommy Bahama's
no, you
awesome.
Got the recipe for DUI.
And drag
Justin race. Bieber?
And
what?
The Dallas Stars last night in the Toronto Maple Leafs game, as they were pummeling the Leafs, they put up Maple Leafs number one fan and Justin Bieber's mugshot on the corner.
That is awesome.
Justin like, Bieber has the best mugshot of anyone.
Yeah.
And the crowd went wild, right?
The whole Twitter sphere went wild.
Oh, that's
I saw you
awesome.
Post it.
Justin Bieber's mugshot... He looks exactly like Miley Cyrus.
He does.
His haircut, his face.
Have you seen it?
Justin Bieber is Miley Cyrus. They are one and the same person.
In fact,
just,
oh,
say,
just
Hubert.
Say Hubert. Okay, thank
fact,
you.
We should do pictures of him naked on the wrecking ball.
Right.
Right.
Thank you, Brick Terminator. I'm glad you're enjoying the show.
Geek Beat Live just went live.
Oh, how about that? You get notifications of when we go live?
Yeah.
How, what's the word I'm looking for? Like, vain is that?
Oh, yeah, right.
John, what did you say? NAS made awesome?
Yeah. No,
no.
I said...
Storage made awesome?
I think I said storage made awesome.
I don't remember. Where was that? That's on the Geek
In the
Beat
ad
website.
I made up.
Hey, somebody go to geekbeat.tv and tell me what the QNAP... Oh, it may not show up because it's on a rotating. Never mind. My plan is shut down.
I thought you were going to say my plan is shh.
No.
Are you practicing?
Digital Phil, are you a huge fan of Miley?
Yeah, but put an exclamation point after it.
Oh, God.
Why is the lint following me around?
What?
I've got like fuzzies flying on my face.
Digital Phil, why do you keep asking me to? You know what? I'll tell you what. Just go ahead and invite me to all the With Friends games. Just send invitations to me to all of them.
Digital Phil doesn't even.
I'll get right on it. Mark Ramsey here? Hey, Mark
Ramsey.
Oh,
hey, Mark.
Smart watchy. That's you.
This yeah.
Mark Ramsey's fault right here, baby.
Thank you, Mark.
Am I sick?
He actually pays attention to his text messages now because they vibrate on his wrist.
Yeah.
Otherwise,
That's true.
Just, he ignores them.
That's true. No, I'm not sick, but my allergies are kind of giving me a little bit of a hard time lately, so I might sound a little bit nasally.
Yeah.
A little more than normal.
Yes, I've got fruit flies, Mark.
Yeah. Huh? I'm talking. And let's see, what did we have for breakfast today? Nothing, because we never had breakfast. That's what.
Yeah, that's funny. That's it. Like, so when you're doing videos, before you start an interview, let's say, a typical question to get somebody talking so that the audio guy can determine that the audio is good, they have to talk a lot. And you can't just say, talk. Because yeah. They don't know what to say. They freeze up. And so we usually say, what did you have for breakfast this morning? And that gets them talking a little bit. So
except for when they go, I didn't eat breakfast.
Yeah, it's like at CES, every single person never eats breakfast. And so that turned out to be a horrible question.
Yep.
And then we just give them sandwiches. Here,
we've got extras.
Okay. Well, read me your credit card number then, live on
right.
The air.
David Foster just got his shipment notification on Pebble.
Awesome. His what notification?
Shipment. Ha ha.
Nice.
Hey, Pablo, could you do me a huge favor, please? Can I get some water? Thank you.
Hi, Rami. How are you?
I forgot.
And yes, you're right, John Rush. I did ask what they had for lunch for many of them. And actually, probably 75% of them did have lunch. And then the follow-up question mm-hmm. was, first I asked what they had for lunch, then I asked, was it any good?
That's a good follow-up question. I like your interview style.
Yeah. Then we got like a 50-50 response. Like some people were like, yeah, it was actually surprisingly good. And then some people were like, it was
oh, no.
Shut up. It was not good. And then we had to further delve into where did these meals come from. And
well, of course, because you don't want to go eat somewhere that
right.
is bad.
Certain places, not so good.
Which places?
I don't know.
Well,
pretty much anything in the convention center.
You mistakenly think that
you were actually paying attention.
Asked them a question and they answered it, that I was listening to the answer to that question. That would be a foolish mistake.
Digital Phil wants to play What's in Your Wallet, and Bobbage said that you don't have any money because Holly's in the studio.
Right. I don't think Holly even knows about that game.
Yeah, I don't think she would want to know about that game, actually. That is not probably a...
Did you hear that?
Do you...
No, I have never played a game where people guess how much cash I have, and if they guess right, I would give it to them. That has never happened.
That is the rule if we play it. Had Holly Post gets the money.
Is it a verve allergy I've got? The only verve allergy I've got is when I don't get enough, then I go into convulsions.
Exactly.
Does the stream keep lagging for everyone else? We need to unplug some of the drop cams.
I think only just the one that's on.
What about the one on my desk?
Not the one on your desk, though.
We can just... I thought we were just going to turn them off as opposed to unplug them.
Yeah, I turned them off.
Oh, okay.
You can just unplug mine. We should have plenty of outgoing bandwidth unless somebody's like uploading something. Dave...
David Foster has never played the What's in John's Wallet game, apparently, because he just guessed
$47. $47. Woo. You're off by a little bit, David.
What I don't like is when John says, it's in my pocket, come get it. that's just uncomfortable.
Well, I mean, you know, you got to earn it. You got to earn it.
Right.
Yeah, but every day.
GH1, we're live streaming on Ustream.
Go to geekme.tv/live. And yeah, because if you're watching on the drop cam.
Test.
Is that drop cam test. On?
It's
or
that
is?
One.
Is
on
oh, that one.
One
over there. So that drop cam is like giving you a really low quality stream.
Yeah.
And if you go to geekme.tv/live, you get the high definition stream.
Eric, I'm so glad Gmail isn't down. People have been accusing me of breaking Gmail because apparently it was down for a little while today.
Ben put in his guess, apparently.
Nice. We're not playing the game. At Holly Poses here. Shh.
You guys are going to blow it. The game will never be played again if you try and play it today with Kahali here.
Hey, what do we have for Verve as far as Lower Thirds go? What do you want?
Oh, vervegeek.com.
John P's ninja name is forward slash. That would be
true.
A good ninja name for me.
Wait, ninjas have names? Like a ninja name? Like
you
a stripper
to,
name?
You have to refer to
them. How do you
get them?
Your ninja name? I don't know.
You have to kill somebody. That's how you get a ninja name. You get a ninja name when you get a proper ninja sword.
I have a proper ninja sword.
Don't touch the sword.
Oops, I've heard that.
I was just about to do this.
Has John P. killed a man? The question is not, have I killed a man?
It's how many. How many has he left alive
in
is
what,
the real question.
Yeah, that's the question.
I like that forward slash. That is awesome.
Bogomil said, you know, lately I realized, huh?
No.
V-E-R-V-E.
No, is it all caps? David?
No. Just normal
caps. I don't
think so. Normal case.
Normal
you know,
case.
Lately I realized that GeekBeat is my primary source of tech geek news. Don't need anything else these days. Thanks, guys.
Aww.
Thank you.
Thanks, Pogomel.
Although, if...
.com, correct.
If we are your primary source of news, woo! I am sorry about that. You are woefully misinformed.
You like that?
Just kidding.
You like that, John?
Strike a nerve.
Yes, nice. Nice.
Oh, I don't have to poke my eye out. John P. will do that for me.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, you knew it's going to come up.
Digital Phil wants me to take him to the Super Bowl.
The Super Bowl is getting canceled.
Do you know how damn cold it is where they're having the Super Bowl? Hell no, we're not going to the Super Bowl. Digital Phil wants to borrow $2. I mean, that reminds me of that movie. What's it called, Holly?
Better Off Dead.
I want my $2.
I'm so glad when you're here, Holly, because I don't get his movie references. So it's a lot easier when he's asking me.
Get excited. Talk.
Yay! I'm excited.
Are you going to watch the Super Bowl?
Yeah, I love the Super Bowl. I love football.
Who do you think's going to win this year?
Football. I have no idea who's playing.
You should have said the best team. You should have said, I think the best team. The one with the best quarterback, that's the one that's going to win this year.
The one with the prettiest uniforms.
That's how I won, a bunch of money at
check,
horse racing.
Check.
Isn't Dallas going to win this year? I think Dallas should win the Super Bowl, don't you? Definitely. Well, Dallas. My money is on Dallas winning the Super Bowl this year.
I love watching sports. Right, exactly. I love watching sports, but I really don't care who's playing. And I think it's better that way because I don't get caught up in, you can just enjoy the plays for the plays themselves, right? You don't get caught up in.
The Mavericks and the Canucks.
The Mavericks. And the Canucks. I thought it was the Mavericks versus the Stars.
It's the Mavericks versus the Canucks, and they're playing in Belfast.
Oh, right.
Right.
Ireland.
Right. Are we ready G'day, to
mate.
Go yet?
Oh, for hours. We're
Why is John so much louder than Callie?
Why are you louder than me? Because
I can't work and diddle the volume at the same time constantly. Whoa, now, Tom. We don't talk about diddling volume knobs and whatnot
around here. This
is a family-friendly show.
They're asking if my mic is actually on.
Yeah, seriously.
But you're not talking as loud.
I am talking as loud as I'm going to.
You need to.
To
turn me down a little bit, Dave. Balance damn audio. Uh-oh, Max is speaking Russian.
I'm talking.
Hello. Hello, everybody from Russia. Hello, Max.
Hey, Russia. Hey, Russia. Hi to all of Russia.
Hello to all of Russia, including Max. Welcome, Max. We're glad to have you. Watching from way across the pond.
Nice. I like how he's writing in it.
This yeah, it's pretty badass.
This cat is freaking me out.
Yes. Just staring at you. Do not. Oh, you just hurt his feelings.
That, well, no,
he just called Creepy this, a piece of crap.
Somebody put this cat right in front
Green
of me.
Green is in the house. Hello, Green. How are you? So we've got Green in China. We've got Max over there in Russia.
Wow.
Hubert's in the Netherlands.
The Netherlands, yep. Did we have Michael?
Yeah, Jenny. No, Jenny is Jenny's Danish, right?
Finland.
Finnish.
Michael Moffat. Did we have a liquid lunch?
Uh-oh. Jenny's speaking.
Meaning we're a little crazy.
Jenny's speaking Martian or something.
I don't understand.
Digital Phil wants me to say something in Greek. Okay, skata.
John Sr., can you come up here and actually speak Greek?
No, he's not
like,
allowed to.
Oh, no.
Where do you think I learned skata?
What does that mean? It's a bad word?
We're not really allowed to say that on TV, but hey.
Nobody knew it was bad until
asked,
I said.
So.
Is that the only thing you know?
Howdy guessed 36953? No.
What?
Parakalo enobukali nero.
Yeah. Exactly.
I asked you if I can have the bottle of water.
No, you cannot. Guess 92575, what's the show about? Nice. So,
what is this show about?
Right now we're in pre-show
Nothing.
Mode.
It's like Seinfeld.
We have no
We're the Seinfeld
agenda.
Of streaming media.
Right.
This is a show about nothing.
Right. In a few minutes, when everybody gets their crap together, we might actually have a show about tech news.
Right.
Here we go. Why do you keep buffering
Mexico.
Ustream?
I'm...
Oh, you're in Mexico. Hola,
nice.
¿Cómo está? We love Mexico. And we love Mexican food. Mm. Uh-huh.
Alright, so Kelly, you're going to kick it. Here we go. Are we ready?
Digital
no,
Phil
I don't
prefers
remember what
this
I said. Let's see.
Can
I say notes? From hearing the conversations? Okay.
Yes, Eric, that is a katana.
Ready.
Oh.
Oh, Simoril is in Montreal, Canada.
Nice.
Man, I love Montreal. Beautiful place.
I've never been.
Except that right now it's probably buried under 14 feet of snow. But.
But we know there's beauty under there.
Yeah, somewhere underneath all that mess, it's a beautiful place.
All right, here we go. And.
Here we go.
All right, and in three.
Hey folks, I'm John P.
And I'm Callie Lewis. Today on GeekBeat Live, how to keep the NSA from hearing your conversations.
Google Glass will get you arrested.
Would you live inside the Enterprise?
T-Mobile is at it again.
And I got a dog. It all starts now. Guys, welcome to GeekBeat Live.
Welcome back to another round of punishment for yet another week of GeekBeat Live. I can't believe you guys come back week
Why
after week.
Why are you watching?
It's amazing. It's amazing. We love you, though. Thank you for coming back. What is this, episode number
122.
122? They let us put this on TV 100 times?
More than. So you guys, because it is episode 122... Not really because, but you guys can go to geekbeat.tv/live122 to see all the notes. Ben is hard at work making sure you guys have the links to the videos that we're going to show you, to the stories that we're going to talk about, all that good stuff.
Nice.
I never remembered to actually say that at the beginning of the show.
Well, now you
I'm
did.
I'm pretty proud of myself.
And you can also check in on Get Glue if you go to... Is it geekbeat.tv/glue check-in, I believe?
I don't know. Somebody took it out of our notes.
It's out of the notes, but I'm pretty sure that's what it is. Check in, because you can only do that when you're watching the show, when we're live.
Right.
So do it. Check it in, baby.
So a couple of updates for you guys.
A lot of stuff happening.
Lots of stuff. One, Bad parking cards.
The bad parking cards?
Yes.
Are there any left?
We just have a few left.
Okay. We've ordered more, but...
The deal is, so you know how, if you watched our packing of the boxes, we were stuffing, like, we told you that we'll give you 250 of these bad parking cards.
But we don't count very well.
But we don't count very well. So you wound up with, like, 350, 400,
maybe 400, 450, I don't know, a lot.
But unfortunately, when these are out and we get more in, we're going to have to actually pack in 250.
That's right.
Because of shipping costs.
There's all kinds of problems.
And we're going to make Pablo count them.
That's right.
Yes, Pablo will be counting them. One.
The problem is, it turns out that when you want to sell massive quantities of something... It needs to all weigh the same amount.
It turns out.
Who knew? So, and Amazon doesn't want to ship it for us if we don't have them. So then we have to do it all manually ourselves. Anyway, point is, if you want to get a big old batch of bad parking cards, you better go now to the phone ringing. Badparkingcards.com.
Yes.
It takes you right to the Amazon page where you can order one of the last batches of the big ones. After that... We'll still be able to get them.
Oh, yeah. They'll still be available.
There may be a gap for a few weeks while the new ones are coming in and getting boxed up, and then there'll be the little 250 pack instead of the big giant pack.
Anyway, so that's that update.
The replacements have shipped, and they will be here next week.
Callie got a dog.
Actually, you got me this dog for Christmas.
You got a dog for Christmas.
His name is Zoomer. Oh, I just turned him off.
You turned him off.
This is Zoomer. Meet Zoomer. He's a little robotic dog. You hear that? He's so cute. Actually, he...
Hi, Zoomer.
Hi, Zoomer. How you doing? What? Don't
He's going to drive right off the table.
Hey, Callie.
Yes.
I caught him trying to hump my USB hard drive.
Are you getting a close-up of this, Dave?
He does. He does like to hump things. He follows commands, so I can tell him... Hold on, Zoomer. Zoomer, play dead. Oh, Zoomer, play dead. He'll actually work on commands, and then he will do his own little thing if you leave him alone for a while.
Nice.
And anyway, he's really adorable. I love my puppy, and I'm sure everybody here is annoyed at having him at work. All right.
He could get a little bit annoying after a while.
Yes, he could.
All right, a few other little updates. First of all, I had a few questions. Nice. We had a few questions. First of all, thank you to all of you guys who've gone in and signed up as patrons.
Yes.
We love you. It helps us continue bringing you the show.
Thank you.
Go to geekbee.tv/patron or patrons. Either one, it'll take you right there. You can pledge. Even like $1 a month helps us keep this thing going. But... for those of you who pledge at the $25 level and above, one of the benefits of being at the higher pledge level is Callie and I are doing...
monthly hangout, a Google Hangout with you guys. So each month we'll just sit down and we'll just hang out and chat. And talk about whatever. You know, just.
So we did a couple of those.
Yes.
And someone asked, I said, well, if I didn't get signed up for that level beforehand, did I just miss out or what?
Right.
No! Actually, the hangouts that we did got recorded, and they're all in the Patreon system.
Yes.
So even if you were to sign up after the fact, you can go back through the archive, and you can see all the different things that we've shared. So at any time when you sign up as a patron, you can go back and get access to all the stuff we've shared that you didn't get to see before.
Yeah.
So
awesome. Well, thank you guys again.
One more big thing that we have to talk about today. I'll just put that right there because we might need to slice something in a minute.
Last time you had something dangerous. Oh.
It's Callie's birthday tomorrow. Yay.
Holly
made these. These are her patented cherry chocolate cakes.
Thank you, Holly.
But we need to light your candle. So let me just get that going right there. That ought to do it. Okay, yeah, that ought to do it. So you can just blow that out and whatnot.
Thank you, everyone.
Make a wish.
Awesome.
All right. Wonderful. Well, we're going to take a quick commercial break. We'll be right back, and she'll scarf that thing down during the commercial break.
And we're back.
And we're back.
Awesome, thank you. What's the question of the day?
They want to sing?
No,
everybody wants to sing?
No, guys.
Yeah.
The question of the day, why haven't you ordered Verve yet?
Yeah.
Yeah. Alan is from Dallas but lives in Clarksville, Tennessee.
Oh. Well,
Eric
when you,
said,
if
was
you
my
come
question.
Back.
You can't ask a question to ask if your question had been answered when you're away after you asked a question.
What?
I just had an aneurysm trying to
figure out. I'm just really
confused. But yes,
now.
Eric, if your question was, is this a katana? Yes, it is a real sword.
Was
real
that his
sword.
Question?
If that was your question, this is a real sword.
You haven't sharpened that, have you?
It is shaving sharp.
Nice.
Don't
hey,
mess with
the. Know is, are there any more cupcakes, Holly?
Yeah, she brought cupcakes
course,
for everybody.
She didn't just make one.
Cupcakes for all. Any news from Paul Dixon's Kickstarter? No.
What?
What's his Kickstarter?
It's not Paul Dixon's Kickstarter, people.
Oh, yeah, okay, I know what you're talking about.
It's the tricopter. No, they have not responded to my email.
I was going to feel really out of it.
I don't know. Maybe they didn't like the fact that I gave them publicity on the show because I said that I had a few questions, but I said it was a cool thing, but I haven't gotten any responses, so I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know what to say.
Well, they've already, maybe they just don't feel like, I don't know, they need to since they have already gotten.
I don't know. I just know that it's time
goal.
To pop open the Verve.
Ah!
Oops.
Pablo.
Pablo.
Sorry.
Lightly carbonated and
ow,
100%
garbage.
Delicious.
I'm going to wait until I actually... Until the show comes back on for mine.
Okay, you go ahead.
It's nice and cold.
Delicious.
A little too cold.
And you guys can order some too if you go to vervegeek.com.
Yes, you can.
Oh, and you should order some, by the way, because John P. said so.
Yeah, Holly, you're so sweet. Delivering cupcakes to everybody.
Nice.
What do you think, Al? Everybody loves her chocolate cherry cupcakes.
Pablo shook it up, Michael said. Did you shake up my Verve?
Nice, Pablo. He's getting a close-up. It's not like Dave is actually at the TriCaster in order to do anything
yeah,
about that close-up.
Right now,
he's
just
too
so
busy getting cherry
just
chocolate
so you
cupcakes.
All know, the whole place here is in a state of disarray because everybody's eating cherry chocolate cupcakes.
Thanks, Holly.
That Holly made. So, and Pablo is trying to Pablo, it's... You mistakenly think that Dave is going to switch to your cupcake
Look
cam.
Look at he did.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Now take a big bite out of it and then show him what it looks like in the middle.
Ben would like you to know that his birthday is in October.
Right. There. Let's see what it looks like inside. Oh,
nice.
That's the cupcake.
All
Look
moist
at
and fluffy.
That.
Well, you can't get this on cable.
No, you can't get... Oh, it is on cable. I guess you can. You can only get this on cable.
What? Al just ran fleeing from the scene. He's like, oh, I don't know why John Sr. brought me to this mess.
I could have stayed in Kansas.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Ready to come back?
In a minute, I'm eating.
Oh, come on.
Let's do this. Here we go.
Jeez.
You don't need to talk. You just need to push buttons.
There's icing on them. Can we get another control surface, please?
Oh, God.
The wheels are off the bus.
They have been off the bus. Today has been.
You know what's going to be funny? When Ken shoots your eye out. Because he's playing with the camera. I mean, playing with the gun over there.
It doesn't have anything on it.
Captain Depth perception over there.
Oh, we didn't scare him away. He went to go get refreshments. I thought we scared you away, Al. I was
nice.
Pretty sure. He's like, ah, too
he's
much.
Crazy.
Not in Kansas anymore.
He's going to disavow his relationship to us.
Yeah.
No, I'm not related to that family.
He's like, I will never go
about
to another family
that.
Reunion
no.
ever again.
No.
Big mistake.
Not going to do it.
All right, here we go, kids. And in three.
tea. Mm. You're already drinking your Verve. Ugh. Mm. Oh. Well, I'm going to get into mine, too.
I did these
are awesome.
Yep, this is our Verve energy drink.
So good that you have to lick it off of you if you get it.
Look, how do you like that? Strike a nerve. Drink some Verve.
Nice. Okay, so you guys have seen us talking about these. These are awesome drinks. They're like energy drinks, but they're healthy energy drinks.
Listen to this. Okay, this is what's in it. Vitamin A, 50% of your daily value. Vitamin C, 500%. Vitamin D3, 250%. Vitamin E, 200%. I could do this for the next half hour, folks.
Nice.
Okay? It's got all these freaking vitamins and all kinds of stuff in it. It's ridiculous. And it's only 45 calories.
I know.
Which is a little bit more
than your Mountain Dew Code Red.
Than this.
Just a little.
I'm going to drink them both just to see what happens.
Oh, God. Please,
hey,
no.
You never know. You never know. So, and yes, Monty said, are they a sponsor? Yes. Verve is a sponsor. So you know what you guys should do?
Go to vervegeek.com and thank them for supporting the show.
Don't just thank them. Order some, okay? Because it's good stuff. And the more you order, the more they sponsor. And the more that they sponsor, the more Geek Beat you get.
You see, it's a big circular kind of thing.
If you don't like carbonation, par tea. This is like a tea drink, and it is amazing. There's no carbonation. It tastes like juice.
Just go bold.
Okay. We're going to get into the gadget news today.
Gadget news?
Actually,
I thought it was just news.
Just news.
All right.
The news stories of the day.
The most ridiculous news story of the week is Google Glass related. You know Google Glass. It's the actual glasses type camera thing. Well, some guy.
What is that?
Some guy actually had the had prescription lenses attached to his Google Glass, and he went to a movie theater, the AMC 30 at Easton Town Center in Columbus, Ohio.
And get
Let's
this.
Make sure that we caught that.
Right.
That was the AMC 30 at the Easton Town Center in Columbus, Ohio.
Don't go there with any technology.
Links in the show notes, along with a Google map.
So he and his wife or girlfriend or somebody, they're in the movie. They're enjoying their movie experience.
His wife.
And
his girlfriend's day,
in comes...
Yeah, his girlfriend's day.
Right. And in come... Get this.
This is unbelievable.
Immigration officers.
Homeland Security and immigration officers coming. So what happened was the guy was sitting there not using his Google glasses.
Just watching a movie.
But he was just watching a movie. Some douchebag in the freaking movie theater called the Department of Homeland Security.
No, they called the
immigration.
No, the MPAA or whoever's in charge of the movie things. Ours, whatever. Yeah. And they somehow got the immigration officers in there and Homeland Security.
What this says,
that doesn't make any sense.
What Ben put in the notes is,
I read the actual article.
While he was in the movie, AMC had contacted Homeland Security Investigations, part of Immigrations and Custom Enforcement, about the patron possibly taping the movie. So you know what? It's written down. That's a fact. Okay? So some douchebag
contacts... MPAA. Thank you, Digital Phil.
Well, they're full of douchebags, too. Some douchebag contacts freaking Homeland Security on some guy sitting there watching a movie. You know what they did? Dragged his ass out of there in handcuffs, arrested him, took him to jail for hours.
Three-hour investigation.
Interrogating him and his wife in different rooms... Until finally he gave them the Google Glass and they could see it had not even been on. They're prescription lenses in it. They're just glasses. And you know what they did to make it right for him?
Give it back.
They gave him a free pair of movie tickets. Swear to God, that is a true story.
Oh, well, he's gonna
That happened at the AMC 30 at Easton Town Center in Columbus, Ohio.
Meanwhile, terrorists are planning to bomb the Olympics.
Exactly.
Right.
This guy's not going to record Captain Phillips, damn it.
Okay.
Anyway.
Speaking about being disruptive, T-Mobile is at it again.
Yeah, T-Mobile is disrupting the banking market.
But in a good way.
Did I just say banking market?
You did.
I did, actually.
Yeah, T-Mobile banking?
Yeah, I know. They actually have been disrupting the entire phone industry cellular market, the world, all year long.
Yeah.
And now,
why
in 2014, they go into the banking industry. So they have said now that you can do your banking through them, and they've opened it up. You just have to go into a T-Mobile store, and you can get a debit card, and you can deposit cash and act like it's a real bank.
Nice.
Are they doing anything with Bitcoin?
Yeah.
Right. No Bitcoins.
Why not get your T-Mobile Visa card and make a phone call on your T-Mobile phone? Why
Very
not?
Interesting. Verizon also, well, back to the actual phone market. If you, we
this
have
is
an
interesting.
International
I like
audience.
This.
I love yeah. this. This is fantastic. You
$5 global SMS, basically. I mean, you know, what's happened in the past is it would cost, wait, is this, hang on, did
yes.
I read this correctly?
$5 a month.
Yeah.
And you get
world
unlimited.
Messaging unlimited.
Yes.
So you can, so what happens is, let's say you've got friends or relatives in another country. A lot of times they'll charge you like 20, 25 cents for
per
freaking
message, yeah.
per text. Imagine you go back and forth
it's
a
really
few
expensive.
Texts with somebody, it'll crush you. But now, let's say your family lives over in Greece and you want to send them text messages, you pay $5 a month and just go at it.
Yeah.
Which actually makes sense because $5 a month is still about 1,000,000,000% profit because these are text messages, people.
Okay.
They shouldn't have charged all that money
let's
anyway.
Call Homeland
it's okay.
Security.
Yeah, let's call Homeland Security.
All right, well,
I'm a little pissed off about that.
I'm going to let John go and have a little break and calm himself down, maybe drink some Verve.
Finish
bold.
My Verve here.
we're going to come right back and talk about more gadgets. But before we do,
I want to know, what would you do if Homeland Security dragged your ass out of a movie theater for no good reason? That is today's question of the day. What would you do?
So all you have to do is go to geekbeat.tv/famespot and leave us a 15-second video, and you can actually wind up on the show during the commercial breaks. How
yeah.
awesome is that?
Why
go.
Not?
Now. Now.
Timing is everything. Good job. Now. Now. Throw a shoe at the
camera. Yeah.
Get out of here.
So is Verve replacing Mountain Dew on the set?
Yes. And speaking of, get that thing off.
When I finish the Verve, I'm going to drink the Mountain Dew Code Red. Then we're going to find out what happened.
Verve is a Mountain Dew Code Red
chaser. Yeah. Okay. look at B Fish.
What?
This is John P. This is John P on Verve. Any questions? Okay.
We do need a poster like that.
So that's as you
awesome.
Guys may know, Lynn is my pusher.
Yeah.
He's always bringing me this Mountain Dew Code Red, so you can blame him. But he knew that I was on a diet, so guess what he brought me?
Nice.
Diet Mountain Dew Code Red.
I didn't know they had that.
Yeah, I didn't either. So here's the thing. I drank some. It's zero calories.
Really?
Okay, it is zero calories. I drank it. It tastes almost exactly like Mountain Dew Code Red. But there's one problem.
It's not Verve. Strike a nerve.
Okay, Verve. That's right. That's the problem. It's not Verve. The sugar.
It's high.
0 grams of sugar, okay? And in this one, the sugar, 77 grams of sugar.
How many pounds is that?
77 grams. That's like 12 pounds of sugar.
Right.
In one bottle, okay?
An entire sack of sugar.
So, this tastes delicious, but it just doesn't work the way this one does, if you know what I mean. And I think you do.
Wow.
No wrestling with the diet.
So.
Yes, Paul, yeah. I mix mine with vodka, you know. Get the...
Yeah, for breakfast.
All right, for breakfast.
She makes Harvey...
All day long.
Yeah, Harvey Wallbangers.
Oh, KJIO says lots of Africa telcos do banking and mobile phones.
Yes, that is a common thing in other countries,
that.
But not in the U.S.
Wow.
That kind of makes sense, though, if you think about it.
Well, they're dealing with, like, you know... you know, credits and stuff like that all the time anyway, so why not?
No, it's
nice.
Huh?
Is Verve sugar-free? Big Daddy T wants to know, is Verve sugar-free?
Yeah. I mean, right.
That is electronic payment all the way through.
There are 5 grams of sugar. There's 5 grams of sugar in this can.
Yeah,
as compared to 77 in that bottle of Mountain Dew.
Guys, just to be clear, Paul likes to think that my red cup that I'm always drinking out of it has vodka in it when it's water.
Yeah.
And I'm not an alcoholic. They're like going crazy in the chat right. room.
Well, also, you're a functioning by the way, alcoholic.
Yeah, functioning. Very, very you're a high functioning alcoholic.
High functioning alcoholic.
Listen, here. This is an energy drink. Don't get me wrong, okay? Here's the things that it has in energy. It has 1 gram of taurine.
What is that?
Actually, taurine. It's, I'll tell you, taurine is to counteract.
It's good
all
stuff.
All the other stuff. It keeps your heart from exploding.
Nice. It has 120 milligrams of caffeine, which is I think about as much as a cup of coffee. It has 50 milligrams of D-ribose.
Oh, my God.
50 milligrams of inositol. And 10 milligrams of choline chloride. And 100 milligrams of delicious.
Nice. You know, as Chris actually said, per serving... Yeah. On the Mountain Dew. You said they had like how many?
It's 77 grams per bottle.
Oh, per bottle. Okay.
Per bottle. That would be funny if it was 77 grams.
Per serving. And there's two servings in there.
Per serving.
That would be awesome.
What planet is taurine?
All right. Are we ready to come back?
All right.
Is taurine in the Milky Way or the Snickers?
James. Right. That's funny. James. So many numbers. Yeah, what are we? This isn't a math show. Let's move. Let's get on with it. All right, here we go, people. Time for gadgets. Ready?
Oh, by the way, Green said she likes to mix rose and... Did she say vodka? Rose and vodka? What is that? Anyway, interesting. Okay, now we can go.
Hey guys, welcome back to Geek Beat Live. I'm a little more calm now that we've had a chance to have a break.
Well, I think you might actually get uncalm now because our next story is...
What is it?
All about the NSA.
What are they doing now?
So, you know how everybody's all up in arms these days about security and the NSA listening in on our conversations and all of that good, horrible stuff. Well,
people have been listening in on my conversations in my head for years.
Yeah, we don't talk about that in public.
Oh, okay.
So a bunch of geeks got together and created the Black Phone. Now, this is an Android.
Is that like a phone for really high credit worthy people?
No, it is a phone to it's actually really, really secure. It's an Android based phone running private OS. Which is basically all encrypted. It's not tied to any cell carrier, you know, any the major carriers.
Hey, so. John, weren't you in the Marines with private OS?
Yes,
right.
Private OS.
And so
this
phone is the most secure that you can get.
Is that the picture of the phone? It's just black. It's just a black screen, Dave.
I wasn't here to gather assets. I'm going to have to.
In fact, this phone is
a memo.
The phone is so secretive, we can't even show you a picture of it.
Nice, that's funny.
That's how secretive it is. We can't even show you the picture of the show right now. We're not even allowed to talk about it.
So anyway, this phone, as secretive as it is available for you to get and to use and to stay secure.
You think that if I stick a Verizon SIM in, it'll even work?
I haven't actually seen any information about
that. That's because it's so secretive, we can't even give you the information. In fact, we're probably going to be executed just because we told you about this black phone.
You can't even make a phone call on that.
I know.
All right. Now it's time for you to calm down a little bit. And
I like this next
towards
one.
Towards the future.
I like this one a lot.
Because it came from MIT.
Oh, God.
Not Harvard.
Here we go. Anyway, some geeks over at MIT developed a new kind of a, let's call it a plastic film that you stick on your glass and it turns it into... a transparent monitor.
How awesome is that? They've been looking for ways to make transparent displays cheaper and more accessible, and they found it.
Well, now the way they did it is they use color nanoparticles in the transparent film, and I guess they apply some current to it, mm-hmm. and bang, it lights up. So just imagine what you could do with this. You could like put this on the inside of car windows. You know, cars have heads-up displays.
Yeah.
They use LEDs that kind of project up onto the screen. Now you could put this film on the window, and you could turn the entire inside of your window into a movie theater watching experience while you're driving down the road. It would be awesome. And the next story.
Please don't do that. Well, you know Dr. Dre, right?
Oh, I know him personally.
Yeah.
College with him.
So Dr. Dre is...
I just call him Dre.
He made... Well, I have to call him Dr.
Sometimes I call him Dre Dre.
Dre Dre, really? Mm-hmm. He created the Beats headphones, right? Well, not him alone, but I don't know where he created it.
Yeah.
And so he made the Beats headphones, and he decided that he and his team would launch a Spotify Pandora-like service. Well, that launched this week, and then it quickly unlaunched.
A streaming media service?
Yes.
Was launched and then retracted.
Exactly. Why this is news, I am not sure. But
so you're telling me it's gone.
Dr. Dre, and he's famous. So
can we get it?
We talk about it.
Can I get it now?
No, no. They are trying to fix some issues. So if you were excited about this service, I would probably stay away until they fix those issues.
Especially because you can't get it.
A word of caution.
Okay, nice. Okay, moving on.
I wouldn't even... Anyway.
Next story. This story I like just because it uses the word zing.
Nice. Datzing.
Yep.
Datzing is a... Well, we've talked about iBeacon before.
What is it?
Well, iBeacon is a way to give you... It's an indoor location system. So, like, GPS is all outdoors, right? But when you go indoors, you can't really map
that. Does it smell good?
No, it's not bacon.
Oh, iBeacon, not bacon.
Exactly.
Oh, okay, sorry.
So this is a system that'll allow you to kind of track inside, indoors, and you could do all sorts of stuff, not just like GPS mapping.
Oh yeah, like if you go to the mall and you're in one place and you want to look up another place, like how do I get there? Then maybe it would help you navigate through the mall
right.
and get to the other place.
And stores can use
IKEA.
Them.
Man, you need one if you go to IKEA. Those places are insane.
That'd be funny, yeah.
Or you know where else you need them?
Yeah.
In the casinos in Las Vegas.
Oh my
goodness,
yes. They turn
those things into mazes
yes.
on purpose. But anyway.
That would be awesome.
So that's iBeacon.
iBeacon launched a couple months ago, and it's all iPhone based. It's all iOS based, and you have to have some hardware.
And if
and
you're on Android,
well,
screw you.
Now, not screw you, because Datzing launched.
Oh.
And it is platform agnostic. And you basically can download this app and start to begin to use it. And the more people that use it, obviously, great. You can turn old devices, like old phones that have Bluetooth, into a beacon, if you will.
Huh.
So go check it out.
What, like
follow
you just
the show
leave
notes.
You just leave your old devices laying around, you know, like breadcrumbs or something?
I do.
Oh, okay.
Hey, John, didn't you used to drive a Datsing?
Yeah, I think I did have a Datsun B210.
Right. So go to geekbeat.tv/live to what?
Bam! 222,
is that
122.
What it says?
122.
Oh, we're not 222. To 222 yet?
You need to remember what time zone you're in
I'm
when you drive
older,
around
I
in your
can't.
Little DeLorean
yeah, okay,
thing with Steve.
Oh, that's awesome.
Okay, we'll be right back after this commercial break.
After
but
these messages.
But before we go, please don't forget, we need to know what the heck you would do if you were dragged out of a movie theater by Homeland Security for no reason at all.
Go to geekbeat.tv/famespot. I couldn't remember if I said the .tv. I really am getting old. Jeez. All right, so hi, Mocha Joe and Jacob Lackey. Welcome to the show, guys.
And Rayshawn Douglas. Whoa. What's happening?
Yeah.
What's up, Jacob?
So is he like Jacob's sidekick?
No.
You know what? You know what we're going to do? But right when we come back from this next one, we're going to do our check-in. Not yet.
Don't do it yet.
Don't touch that keyboard. But be ready. Be ready, because when we get back, you know the drill. We're going to be asking where you're coming at, you know, where you're watching it from, and you're going to say, not yet. But when we tell you to do it, you're just going to bring it. Bring the pain. Not yet.
Are you okay?
Just making sure everybody realizes we're not doing it yet.
What the hell, yeah.
Let's okay, are we ready?
What is this, Monte Quesadillas? What?
Monty.
That's Monty.
You don't know Monty?
Monty.
You know you
Monty.
Really need...
We've been talking about Monty since day one.
I know, but I've never seen it written. Monty
okay, is everybody ready? Oh, GH1 doesn't know the drill.
Oh, GH1, okay.
Well,
so...
you're going to find out in just a minute. It's pretty self-explanatory. Hey, Jike Moan's got the free Velodyne headphones
nice.
In the mail.
Congratulations. Congrats. Everybody's getting their free Velo. Is it Velodyne, I thought?
It's Velodyne. By the way, this is the most Velodyne. Craziest, most amazing thing ever
Seriously.
That I still cannot believe. When we did the interview, well, I did the interview with the Velodyne CEO. She came on the show at CES. She was showing us off these new headphones. They're awesome. They're like $300 a pair. We're like, those are really cool. I'd love to get a pair of those. She goes, guess what? Every single person that goes to the website
this
right now,
sign up page,
we're
going to
give you a free pair. And I was like, wait a minute. Hang on. You mean everybody goes there and you have one pair and you're going to give it to one of those people, right? Because we need to be clear, because they're like a lot of people watching right then. She's like, no, I am going to give everyone a free pair who goes here and registers. I was like, holy crap. And seriously.
Because to be honest, when we do giveaways and stuff, you know, if a company doesn't fulfill their promise, we get the brunt of it. Mm-hmm. Like everybody comes back and yells at us. And so that's a very tricky situation
but
to be
she
in.
Announced it. I mean, we didn't even know this was coming.
Right.
Swear to God, we did not know this was coming. She just, we did our thing. And at the end of it, she was like, go here, fill out the form. We're going to send you a free pair. And so people are getting their $250, $300 pairs of headphones like by the droves.
That's really cool.
Lynn, did you see that? Did you do that?
No, I didn't do it. I saw it. I didn't do it.
Oh,
he doesn't watch our live show.
I can't believe you didn't do it. I would have done it, except I was live and I had to go into my next thing.
Michael
H. said they're last year's model.
Who cares?
Oh, well, I guess last year's car didn't drive.
Yeah, $250.
When you get something free, there's no complaining.
$250 for last year's model, so.
I love it. It's free. They're giving away, they manufacture.
Oh, he said it's only $100.
Oh, it's $100? Still, it's $100.
I thought they were $250.
They manufacture
Maybe the new ones are or something.
Right? Oh, okay, I don't know.
They manufacture products to sell.
Yes.
To make a profit.
Yes.
They give them away.
Michael wasn't complaining.
No, he's not complaining.
No, Michael wasn't complaining.
Yeah. He's just correcting me, which is fair. All right.
Ready?
Are they still doing that? Was it a special URL?
No, I think it was just that, just right then, just that day.
Yeah.
But there were 500 people watching live on the stream that I know of, and God knows how many pairs that they had to give away, so.
All right, let's come back, then we'll do the check-in. Not yet.
Not yet.
And then we'll get on.
Which company did this? Bayou LA? It was Velodyne. During our CES live broadcast, along with like $10,000 worth of other goodies we gave away, Velodyne like probably did that many in like 15 minutes, okay? So.
Here we go.
Hey guys, welcome back to Geek Beat Live. How
We're
are
so
ya?
Glad you joined us yet again today.
Thank you.
And you look smashing.
You're
By the way,
you're such a charmer, John.
It's that time of the day when we check in with the live folks who are watching the show live to find out where in the world are you watching from. So, guys,
yes,
bring the pain. Where are you watching the show from? Type it in. And are you ready to do this?
I am ready. You know, we have people from all over the world. Example, Liverpool,
go.
New York, Lancashire.
Austin, Texas. Bournemouth, UK.
Stonewalk Preserve, Venice, Florida.
St. George, Utah. Portugal.
Nice.
Dubuque. Coventry, UK.
Siltborgen, Denmark.
Netherlands.
Finland.
Mr. Jiggs is outside Beantown.
Taishan, China.
Victoria, BC. Koblenz, Germany. Imatra, Finland. Nash, Vegas, Tennessee.
Nice. Austin, Calgary.
Smoggy Lake, Salt Lake City.
Siltborg, Denmark. I think I already said that. Pittsburgh, just outside of Earth. Oh, on the outside of Earth. Nice.
San Antonio, Texas. Plano, Texas. Falls Church, Virginia. Scotland, UK. Tallahassee, Florida.
Israel.
Homestead.
Florida. Dallas.
Coventry, we saw that one.
Clarksville, Tennessee. Frisco. Wichita Falls. Atlanta, Georgia.
Orville, Ohio. Louisville, Texas. Gothenburg, Sweden.
We've got
Somerville,
another one
New Jersey.
In Israel.
Milky Way. Stockton, California. Dallas. State of Confusion.
Gardner, Kansas. Sweden. Paducah, Kentucky. Friesen in Louisiana.
Baltimore, Maryland. Or as we say, Balmer. Balmer, Maryland.
The moon.
Mike DK is on the moon.
Hopedale, Mass.
Nimrod is in Israel.
Yes, that's what I said earlier.
Brick Terminator, USA, North Carolina.
Aarhus, Denmark. San Jose, California. Glen Heights. Linköping, Sweden. Did you already say that one?
Jani is in Robotlandia.
Nice. Toronto-ish, Canada. Hamburg, Germany. Hopkinton, New Hampshire.
And the list probably
North Carolina.
Continues. But we can't sit here going on all
ooh,
day long.
Ooh, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Rio de Janeiro, Brazil? Wow.
Nice. Wow.
Awesome. Okay, guys.
Thank
Fort
you guys
Mitchell,
so
Kentucky.
Much
we can keep going
for
thanks
staying up of all hours of the year. Of the year
for watching everywhere around the globe. Now it is time for us to move on to science.
Actually, it's time to, for us to go outside of the globe.
Oh.
So, Ceres. I think I'm saying that right. Ceres.
Ceres.
Ceres. Oh yeah, Ceres. That's right. I asked Peterson earlier how to say it, and he told me, and then I forgot. I'm getting old.
Ceres.
Ceres is in the asteroid belt, right? It is the it's a dwarf planet. Well, it turns out they discovered.
Yeah, we call them little planets.
The little ones. So it turns out they may actually have enough water or more water than we do here on Earth.
Fresh water.
Fresh water.
Fresh water.
And so here's what I'm thinking.
Take a
so
little trip.
We send a team out there.
Bottle that stuff up.
No. This is the perfect place we need to go to escape when Earth is no longer any good.
When Earth turns into another asteroid belt.
Exactly. So we just send out a team, melt all the ice because right now it's frozen. So
have a giant swimming pool.
Exactly, and then we go live there.
Okay, sounds good to me.
What do you think?
Skynet will follow.
Sounds
I'm
good
sure
to me. Okay, well, on this next story, you are going to be amazed
am
by
I
what your eyes see. It's going to blow your mind because, you know, there is a little known phenomenon called ball lightning. And this is
lightning?
It's lightning that comes in a ball.
Okay.
And people knew about it, but no one's ever caught it on video before.
Isn't that a superhero thing?
Right. And what happened was, some Chinese researcher guys accidentally caught it. Would you look at this amazing video?
Let's
that's
see
it. Isn't that blowing your mind? Yes, you know it is. That is blowing your mind.
I'm so blown that I can't even talk.
That is ball lightning in action. It's breathtaking.
Nice.
I don't know. These things make their ways around the internet.
My old Sony Trinitron,
when
you turned it off, it would
be... Yeah, that's kind of what happened when I turned my TV off, too. So I don't know. I don't know why everybody got so excited about this, but apparently one of these lightning ball strikes can last for like 2 seconds. It's just nobody's ever caught it on film before, so that was accidentally captured.
Accidents
and now
happen, and then they go viral on YouTube.
To me, right. I kind of thought the video looked a little bit like the old Bigfoot video where he's walking and it's like, was that really Bigfoot? How do I know that was ball lightning? I don't know.
Because you've never seen it before.
But my mind was blown, and that was what was important.
Well, I was blown away at this next story. Yeah. Actually, Janie sent it in, so thanks for that. A woman named Lynn Rainville, she's from Canada, and she's 51 years old. Well, she spent, I don't know how long, but a long time turning her basement at her house into a basic, well, into the Enterprise. And she's nice. Turned it
you sure
every
that's,
Star
sure
Trek.
Not Holly poses
Edie's. Nice. Right.
She made custom furniture. She made the bathroom. Look at that bathroom.
The bathroom it looks like Mr. Spock's quarters.
Yes. And
and
it cost
she
her.
She spent $30,000. Building
actually,
that.
You spent way more renovating your house.
I did.
Right?
And so I didn't even get a I didn't give an didn't Enterprise get, bridge out of it. Holly.
You could have done way better. Guys. She said I wouldn't have complained.
Nice.
What's also pretty cool is, you know, a lot of people do those model airplanes
mm-hmm.
or model whatever. This one guy actually created a model of the Boeing 777.
Yeah, why not?
But his name is
I
Luca.
I got a little spare time. I think I'll take a big stack of paper and turn it into a 777.
He didn't take a stack of paper.
I know it was manila folders
manila
or something.
Manila envelopes.
Manila envelopes?
He made this entirely out of manila envelopes.
Show us, Dave. Now, look at that.
That's awesome.
I know at first you were thinking, what is the inside of that? What's so special about the inside of this airplane? And then all of a sudden you saw tweezers coming in with some little miniature paper seats. And I don't know what to tell you.
How awesome is that?
This is a guy
some
with a little more free time on his hands.
Does it fly?
Than
no,
I have.
It doesn't fly. Does not fly.
I think that it could fly if you soaked it in jet fuel and lit it on
nice.
Fire and just would only do it once. Just once. Yeah, can we get a little more leg room in there? Because
right.
I'm feeling a little cramped just looking at it. No, but that is awesome. Imagine the time and attention to detail it took to do that and the skill.
Yeah.
I couldn't
impressive.
Do that no matter how much time you gave me.
Whew, you got to be patient.
It's like building a ship in a bottle.
Yeah.
All right, it is commercial time. We are going to take a quick break and come back and talk about robots.
Oh, brother.
Yay.
And we're back.
What kind of a serial killer makes that plane? Mark Ramsey.
I think I'm going to show the rest of the pictures of the plane.
Yeah.
More.
Yeah, I noticed. There,
he's showing them now.
He's showing them now.
That is amazing. That is amazing.
Pretty impressive.
That's crazy. Huh.
Americans charging. Okay.
Okay, got awful quiet
sorry,
in here.
I'm doing a little prep, sorry.
Okay, you check out your robots. I'm going to have a little verve because I'm feeling kind of run down, so I need
right.
a little pick me up. Yeah, strike a nerve. Drink some verve. Strike a nerve. Drink more verve.
All right. This is brought to you by verve.
Nice.
Burp, John, real loud.
I can't do that on cue.
Oh, yeah. James actually asked a good question. It says paper cuts. I wonder how many paper cuts that guy got throughout that process.
That is a good question. Maybe he wore leather gloves.
How
while
can
he
you
was
do that
it.
Intricate of work with gloves on?
I
don't think you can.
Well, doctors do it every day.
I thought
gloves.
You knew that I was making a joke.
They like remove spleens. They do stuff in golf.
Yeah, they all have gloves on.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about they use gloves and they do intricate work.
No,
what's
they don't.
What are you talking about?
I don't know.
The doctor that worked on me that did my gallbladder removal didn't have any gloves on.
No.
Yeah, no, he just put a little incision in her belly button and got a toilet plunger and...
He didn't even have an operating room. I mean, these things are not.
It was in Mexico.
You know,
I thought it was fine.
In the back seat of an LCD.
He told me if you have enough tequila, these things just don't matter.
Yeah. I wasn't in any pain.
That's what they sterilized with.
Modern conveniences of antibiotics and clean rooms and toilet paper. I mean, we don't need these things in our lives.
Because it happened in a back alley in Bangkok didn't mean it wasn't a good surgery.
That's right.
You know? He I'm came fine. Highly recommended by the homeless people around. So.
Around Bangkok?
Yes.
Was there a monkey with a cigarette?
He left that. He said cigarettes were bad around surgeries.
That was the nerve.
So. I love how in the chat room they have a whole different conversation.
Yeah, they're
going
just
on.
Like,
so who do you think is superior first officer? Was it Spock or was it?
Is that the chat room? Is that the voice of the chat room?
Yeah, that was my generic voice of the chat room.
All right, are we ready to go?
Mark Ramsey. Rubber gloves don't feel as good as going gloveless.
Yeah. Ben, I didn't have any insurance. Are you? What are you talking about?
Right.
Yeah, they just do it.
If you go to Nuevo Laredo, you don't need insurance.
And you can recover at the Downs.
Okay, let's do this. It's robot time, so let's get it over with as fast as we can. Hey guys, welcome back to Geek Beat Live. It's the time of the show every week that I'm always dreading when we learn new ways that our technology is going to kill us. Care of
Hey,
Callie
I
Lewis.
Want you to shut your mouth because it is my birthday and I can talk about robots if I want to.
That's right, you can.
Right? All right. Actually, you know the little bits kit, right?
Yeah, little
and
bits.
And all of the other subsequent little kits that I've been showing you guys over the past year that are making robotics simpler and easier for younger kids to adapt to.
Yeah.
So Easy Robots have actually come out with a new kit. And
you can get those in Thailand too.
Right.
So the kit is actually, they're snapped together. So basically you assemble the robots by snapping the pieces
like
together.
Legos?
Kind of like Legos. And it makes it really easy. Things, you just follow the instructions. And I think it's really awesome. Take a look at how these are
the end results,
right? That's the Hexapod. It goes for $389, which is not bad for,
Look at that Hexapod.
It's awesome.
That thing is going to climb up on you and stab you in the head with all those pointy legs while you're asleep.
Right.
And this is what we're teaching our children. Look, that's a laser beam. He mounted a laser. Oh, look, it's... it's actually pointing its little fangy legs right at you, like practice. And we are teaching the children?
Shh. Roe V will cost $249. It's a tank. And then...
Of course it is.
Right. And then if you want like a humanoid-looking one, that's $469. So the more expensive of the three. Mm-hmm. But it's running a 120 megahertz ARM Cortex M3 controller. They have Bluetooth or Wi-Fi connections, depending on which one you get. And you just have a program on the computer that you kind of control them with. And I think they even have an app, if I remember correctly. So pretty cool new company in Calgary, Alberta.
Is that new company called Skynet?
No.
Okay.
No.
What else you got?
Actually, this one I think you're really going to like.
Do you mean that I'm really going to like it, or you mean I'm really going to hate it?
I think you're really going to like it, actually. So, okay. You know those industrial robotic arms that they use in like warehouses?
The ones that could just crush people with one single blow?
Yes.
Yeah, I know those very well.
Well, UArm is a new Kickstarter project that has blown... They only asked for $5,000, and they're already like... way past it.
Uh-huh.
They're taking that idea of the large industrial arms and making it into like a little mount for your computer desk monitor stand. So you can now get this.
Wait, you can have a giant robotic arm that you mount your computer on?
Yes.
This arm can lift like tons and you're going to put a 20-pound computer on it?
Well, it's a miniature version.
Oh, okay. It's a miniature
version. So it's not going to be...
Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh.
But then you can have it on your desk and you can,
He's
not attached. He didn't attach the monitor. I saw one picture where it had a monitor attached to it and it was just sitting on the desk.
Okay.
But then you can do all this other stuff too and
By the way,
like,
when
use
I was,
it
when
on
I was
your
a
desk.
Kid, we had a little caterpillar little backhoe things that had handles, and you would just, you could do the exact same thing as that, but you would actually move your arms, and you would move it back and forth.
Why would you do that?
Yeah, I know. I don't know why
you
do that.
John, when I was a kid, I reached over and picked the cups up with my hands.
Yeah, yeah.
What?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes we even moved and, cups with our hands.
And I was a lot faster than that thing.
Yeah. So.
But then you had to do work.
We did work.
And this does it for you.
We also went outside.
I don't know. I see that guy's
we
hand
played
going
Cowboys
crazy
and
over
Indians,
there.
But that's not politically that correct anymore. So I don't know. I don't know.
I think it's pretty cool.
Speaking of cool.
You're going to try and tell me that you have cooler stuff.
It is Planes, Trains, and Automobiles time.
Thank you.
And yes, I am going to tell you I have cooler stuff, starting with what you do when you're buried with snow.
Shovel.
You break out the snow plow.
Yes.
Or if you're lazy.
Actually, you just sit inside with a hot cup of cocoa.
Or if you're lazy and you're a geek. You break out your 1/8 sized Jeep RC control vehicle, you mount a snowplow on the front of it, and you sit inside and plow your snow like this. That's what I'm talking about. That is a remote control.
Wait, how dumb is this thing?
The guy's sitting inside by his fireplace,
oh my God,
driving his little RC-controlled snowplow car.
But he's only going to get buried by the snow. It's so tiny.
And no, it is not. You just got to start when it starts snowing and don't stop.
So the storm that's happening right now is...
It's nothing. This thing could take it on.
No, I don't
Andrew
think so.
Dykiel built this on an Axial SCX-10, which is a 1/10 scale RC version of a Jeep Wrangler Unlimited. And, of course, he put a 1/10 scale snowplow on it. And that's it. The Jeep is sold for about $380, $80 for the snowplow.
Or you could just
$20 for the mount.
A snowplow.
Basically.
Do it yourself. I mean, you were just talking about how people don't do anything these days. And look at what you're telling me.
That doesn't apply to manly RC control vehicles like this. Okay?
You gotta get,
I mean, come on.
What was I thinking?
Somebody had to build that thing. Then they had to carry it out there and put it down. They have to actually manipulate the remote control. It's a very good. It only costs $500, folks. Everybody should have one if you live where there's snow.
Especially in Texas.
Why not? Why not?
Yeah.
Okay, moving on.
Mm-hmm.
The next little project we've got to share with you guys is called the Arrow.
Okay. Like, isn't that the TV service? Oh. Don't do that. You know what happened last week when you pointed anything at my face?
I shot your eye out.
Yes.
I'm surprised Dave doesn't have a little animated gift.
Yeah, why didn't you get that?
But anyway, the Arrow was. The Arrow is a new torpedo like electric vehicle concept.
Wow, look at that fancy thing.
That's right.
Looks like a Can-Am.
Now, what's awesome about it is, first of all, it's got a 30 kilowatt motor in the rear of the vehicle. It's a two-seater, and they're seated in tandem, like in a cockpit of a jet airplane or something.
Yeah.
Okay, and this little sucker, it's four wheels. It's designed to go 370 miles using lithium air batteries.
Wow,
how badass is that?
That's pretty
how
cool.
How fast does it go?
Actually, I don't know how fast it goes.
5 miles an hour takes a month.
It goes 327 miles an hour, Dave. Was that okay with you? So
you'll be there in an hour.
That's right. And so the question is whether they're going to be able to take this from kind of concept into reality. But from my perspective, I think what's cool is, A, there's one. They built it. Okay. Now, the question is, who's going to get that to market? It could be a motorcycle manufacturer like Honda, Yamaha, Suzuki. It could be a new startup company like this. It could be Ford or Toyota or somebody. But if they were to get these out to market in a reasonable price,
I think people would buy them in droves, maybe not to replace their car,
but to augment. I'm seeing at Holly Poe's shaking her head no at the moment.
Hey, John.
I don't think that that's going to be in your garage.
Is this one of those things where you can have a motorcycle license to drive it?
Probably just a normal car license.
Huh.
Anyway, Ken's giving us the old...
All right. Well, because we have unboxings to do. So we're going to take a quick break, get the boxes ready, and we'll be right back.
Before we go, what are they supposed to do at the break? They're
you
supposed to tell us
what.
You
need to make sure that you tell John, so he's not ranting alone, what you would do if the Homeland Security people came in and ripped you out of the movie you're watching and interrogated you for 3 freaking hours.
I'd tell you what I do, but this is a family-friendly show, and I'm not allowed to. So you guys go ahead, go on to geekbeat.tv/FameSpot.
I'm not as good at ranting as you are.
And go at it.
Sorry. You guys try. I have a contact issue I need to step out real quick. Sorry.
Here we were thinking we were dealing with professionals, and they go running off the set. I don't even know what to say. She abandoned you people, but I would never do that. Does she do an impression of me on Code Red? Oh, well, she's never done that. That's something new that would be invented. Huh? She did her Mr. T impression? She did a Mr. T impression? She did. That one time. That was a while back. I pity the fool. Was that her Mr. T? Do you think she would have any different...
No.
It would be her Mr. T, right? Impression of me. If she
probably didn't know it's Mr. T.
No, yeah, she wouldn't. Yeah.
I did a Mr. T impression of you.
Who's Mr. T?
Phil wants you to do an impression of me on Mountain Dew Code Red.
I already did. Doesn't somebody have an animated gif of that? All right. I did the whole pity the fool thing.
I know.
So
yeah.
Y'all want to like move your chairs, stand up, get ready for boxing? Poor John.
I have to stand up. You sorry you came to watch this yet?
Dave Peterson. Dave Peterson said he's thinking we're going to have a bunch of fame spots that won't be airable on TV.
That'd be awesome.
You're probably right.
I'll publish them on my I'll publish them on my Google Plus. Okay. How much time do we theoretically have, Ken?
7 minutes.
Okay. 7 minutes it is.
We can do that.
Do we have a lot?
Huh? No. I'm not really, no.
We got enough.
I mean, we have enough to fill 7 minutes.
Okay. I haven't paid attention to what's coming in.
That's because most of them have wound up on my desk. No, I'm saying because... Never mind.
Okay. Time to unbox
Eric,
all this shizzle,
don't
people.
Don't worry. It wasn't the best segment of all time. Even I will admit to that.
Digital Phil said, John P., who would win, Batman versus Chuck Norris? Me. Next question.
I can't believe you no longer have the ability to say that Chuck Norris is your neighbor.
We drove him out of the neighborhood. There could be only one.
And you won. Wow. That's pretty impressive, John.
Chuck
that's the way I roll.
Keep fooling with John.
Yeah.
Chuck was like, oh, shit, this neighborhood went downhill. I'm getting out fast. Let that John P. guy move in across the street.
Paul says, did he ever sell his house?
Yeah, he sold his house. It's not Chuck Norris's house anymore.
Wow, who is it? Who is the lucky guy? Who is
Bronson.
The lucky?
Yeah, Charles Bronson.
Yeah.
Charles Bronson bought his house.
They got a shrine of Chuck Norris when they bought the house, And they did. And Chuck Norris himself put together the shrine.
That was
Chuck kept throwing his crap over the fence.
Right. That was honestly one of the selling features of the house. Was like, okay, Chuck is leaving his Chuck movie
his
room
shrine
memorabilia in the house. So
yeah,
buy the house.
That's not
for
vain.
$1.2 million.
Okay, let's get this going.
Oh, but by the way, I think they originally listed it for $1.2 million, but I think I saw that it finally sold, but it only sold for like $970,000 or something.
Oh, no.
So wow. I don't know.
Well, you could get a
that's
discount.
A big chunk.
Steven Seagal's
probably
moving
would have
in.
Sold for more had the shrine not been in the
yeah,
house.
I don't know. I don't know.
All right, ready?
It was 7,000... 7,000 and something square feet. 7,500 square feet,
wow.
Chuck's house.
Wow, those houses
one story.
Don't look that big.
7,500 square feet. It was a big house, okay?
Wow.
And what's yours?
Not that big.
A measly, like...
It's pretty big. Our house 6,000? Is pretty big, but it's not that big.
He's not, ours not
is,
that crazy.
Ours is nowhere... I mean, it's definitely not over 6,900.
Yeah.
Definitely not under over 6,900 square feet. I don't know.
All right, ready?
Here we go.
Man. Three. I'm excited.
Are you?
I love unboxings. Don't you guys like unboxings?
I think you especially like unboxings on birthday unboxing day. Because
people made a bigger deal out of it than I intended.
Did I mention that tomorrow's Callie's birthday? Tomorrow's Callie's birthday. So you guys get on the Twitter.
No,
get
no,
on the Twitter
no,
and be
no,
like
no,
at
no,
Callie
no,
Lewis.
Don't do that.
Happy birthday to
don't
you.
Don't do that.
Dot dot dot.
Go
then
get
do
a box.
Another at Callie Lewis. Happy birthday to you. Dot dot dot. At
stop
Callie
it.
Lewis. Happy birthday, dear
Dave,
Callie.
Can you use his mic, please.
Hey, everybody.
Happy birthday to you.
Everybody needs to tweet her a coffee.
Oh, yeah.
So,
tweet me
speaking
some
of happy birthdays, I'm going to deliver this to you as if I were taking credit for it, even though Lynn is the one who bought it and brought it here. But,
Lynn, thank you.
Look at this.
This
I don't even
fancy.
Know. What is this?
It says Cake Ball. It says the Cake Ball
can
Company.
Can you see that? Can you see that? The Cake Ball Company.
Now, Holly makes exceptional cake balls.
Oh, Holly makes the
so
best
the question
cake balls.
Will be, are the Cake Ball Company cake balls...
Where,
I feel wrong saying
what
that
what is
word.
The one cake ball to the cake ball to rule them all.
Right.
All I can
it's
think of right now.
It's time to have a ball, is what this says.
All I can think of right now is South Park.
Oh no no no!
Hey everybody, have you seen my balls? They're big and salty and brown.
Okay, we're moving on. Look how beautiful these look.
If you ever need a big, pick me up. Just put my balls in your mouth.
Oh, Lynn, you know me well. These are white chocolate cake balls. I love me some white chocolate. And look, it has like crystals on there.
Talk about Shaft.
Awesome. Thank you.
They smell delicious.
They do.
They do. Okay. That is not all. Indeed, you have many, many things here. Let's see. Chris Philby sent you a card. We can't read all these cards. We don't have that kind of time. Chris Philby sent you a card. Ricardo Garza sent you a card.
Nice.
BJR, Ben from the D to the B to the U right. to the Q, whatever, Dubuque, Iowa sent you a card.
Wow, guys.
Bruce Reinhardt sent you
wow.
a card. And there are more, I'm sure of it. But
thank you, guys. You guys are so sweet. And what's
also,
that?
This came from Mr. Jason Wynn.
Okay.
Came priority
Jaybird.
Mail.
What is in there?
I don't know. I don't open your packages. Let's see here. What did you right. get? Uh-oh.
Nice.
Bang!
Big Bang Theory.
I mean, Big Bang.
The sixth theory. And seventh season? Cool. I'm sorry, fifth and sixth season.
Nice.
That is because, he says that because I haven't watched it in a while. Because I cut the cable a long time ago. So Big Bang Theory is not actually on like Netflix or Hulu Plus or any of those that I watch.
So you just have to bootleg it. I mean, buy the DVDs.
Right. Thank you, Jason.
That
nice.
Was very,
that was
very,
very
sweet of nice.
You.
Okay, we've got some other unboxings to do. So the question
yes.
is,
You want small, medium, large, or flat?
Flat. Oh, sounds interesting.
Wow, flat. Okay, flat it is. This package came from FedEx.
Yay, thank you, FedEx.
Or via FedEx. Okay, let's see what it is.
All right.
What do we got in package number one?
Oh, yeah. The Nomad. All right.
Okay,
what
it looks like a piece of
yes,
it looks
does.
Like a piece of paper. Oh, wow. Look at this.
This is actually the tiniest, thinnest little charger.
It is the Nomad Charge Card. And it is the world's most portable USB cable. It's 2.5 millimeters thick. It has a flexible link and a standard USB port. And you know what's cool about this one? That little hook right there is to go on your keychain.
Yes.
So this is, so you can have a little lightning connector charger cable that you literally keep on your keychain. So whenever your battery is a little low on your iOS device, you can be like, yep. I forgot my cape. No, I didn't. It's right on my keychain.
And you, cool? You're definitely going to want to keep it on there because otherwise you might lose it.
And look how flexible it is. I mean, you can't break it. It's awesome. We need like
very, very cool.
We need a bunch of these. And you know what else we need? We need a micro USB version of it, which I think they're coming out with. It says Nomad. Something.com. I can't quite read.
HelloNomad.com.
Oh, HelloNomad.com.
Did you really think that that's a NomadSomething.com?
Yeah, that's what I thought. HelloNomad.com. Go get yourself, like, oh, you'd probably be fine with a dozen of these.
Right.
The charge key. Okay?
Cool, very
and send
cool.
me some, too.
And all of a sudden, she'll start leaving her keys at home. Oh.
Right.
That's right. Okay,
exactly.
Now, small, medium, or large?
Small.
Small it is.
I'm going smallest to largest today. Okay. Why am I getting to open everything?
You
wow.
shouldn't, because that's actually to me. That's addressed
right,
to me.
There you go. You open it then.
Okay. Let's see. This one came
from
Hong Kong.
Oh.
No, it's from Hong Kong.
This is Japan.
it came via Hong Kong, probably.
Oh.
I don't know, from Japan. This.
Tokyo Flash?
I have been waiting for this. This is from Tokyo Flash Japan.
Mm-hmm.
You know what they do? Watches. They do watches. And this is a watch they sent me to check out because it's uber geeky. Let's see it.
How is it geeky? What's it got?
Well, you're about to find out. This is the
wow, look at that packaging.
Kisai.
It's like all
Kisai.
And stuff.
Let's see here. And we're getting in here. And we're getting in here.
Okay. Got the black.
And bingo! There it is.
Wow.
So it's got kind of a carbon fibery looking leather thing. But what's interesting, and you guys, I'll have to figure out how to get the battery going on it first. But show that.
Here.
Show that. What this thing does is, It can show the time. It can show the time in a normal kind of fashion, or it can give you these artistic-y looking things that if you know how to read it properly, you can read it and no one else can read the time from your watch.
That's really cool. Why? I mean, because it's such a secret.
Yeah, why would I want you to see?
I mean,
I don't want you to know what time it
right.
is.
Right.
Oh, wow. That is actually, that was already doing it. Look at that.
Oh, wow.
So
that's cool.
I'm going to have to play with it, and then I'll let you guys know. But how awesome is that? It's pretty cool looking.
All right.
Pretty cool looking.
So it's just going to flash 12 the whole time?
Right. Because I won't be able to work it like it was a VCR. Okay, now
right.
you get
medium.
Here we go. Here we go.
Oh, yay. I'm so excited about these.
Oh.
Awesome. Okay.
Ah.
So.
We knew this was coming.
Yes. For the S4.
For those of you who happen to have a Samsung Galaxy S4, just get your wallet out right now.
Yeah, this is really cool. All right. So this is like a camera case. It's a case.
It's a two-piece system.
It's a phone system. It's a case. But.
Do you need a knife? Is it all taped together?
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah,
it is.
Don't cut me.
Does it turn it into the Galaxy camera?
It basically does.
It does turn your phone
Way
into
to
your Galaxy
spoiler it,
camera.
Dave.
It's
a two-part system. So imagine this. You slap this case
onto your phone.
On your phone. Okay.
And then this is what the back looks like. You've got your camera lens hole right there. And does this
That's
move?
The LED. No, that does not move.
Because that
this
attaches.
Attaches on. Look at this
that
little
thing
beauty.
That is amazing.
Okay. This has multiple lenses on it, including a fisheye lens, a macro lens.
We've got circular polarizer.
That's this one. Circular. So polarizer wide is angle. What you use outdoors in like bright light to make the, instead of the sky being all blown out, mm-hmm. it'll keep it blue and nice.
And you've got macro and fisheye.
So you take this bad boy and you like stick it on here. Let me see. Oh, you line up.
This is like those old 1950s television cameras.
Yes, you line that up. Okay, so now we got that there. So your camera, your phone will be there. And then you just turn this and you rotate it into
How
the
awesome
lens
that?
That you want to take the pictures with.
I
locks in place.
So cool. How much is this? You guys tell. Let us know. It's from Stylus. It's called the Revolver Lens.
If I recall, the lens itself is around $60. And then the little handheld.
What's the little pouch thing?
What little pouch? I forgot, but I think.
It's a foldable kickstand.
No. Oh, yeah, you can use that as a kickstand, right. But also, it's got a place where you can put like a little wrist strap. And also, if you look right here at the top corner, right there and over here, there are also little hook things. So you could wear this around your neck, like you could hang it like a little, like a camera, like
yeah,
a real
yeah,
camera.
Yeah.
You could hang it around your neck. And cool. So anyway, what's cool is this case is specifically made for the S4. They're going to make these for other phones in the future, so you don't have to throw away your lens. You could take your lens off this one and put it, you know, just change that out for other phones.
Very, very cool.
Very cool.
All right, what else? One more.
One last box, and this one is almost certainly for you because this is from Boca Java.
Ooh.
Boca Java.
Java means coffee.
Yeah, it does.
All right, what do we have?
What do you have? I got to put my watch on while you're doing that. What do we
that
have?
That is funny. Maple bacon morning. I tweeted about this a
oh
long
my
time
God.
Ago. This is maple bacon coffee from Campy.
I'm not
Thank
making
you,
a
Campy.
Joke. It smells like bacon.
It does.
It smells like it smells like honey and bacon. Amazing.
Thank you, Campy. That is so sweet.
Will you
I
actually
can't wait
drink
to
that?
Drink it. Of course I will.
Okay,
what
I'm going to I'm going to put my watch on. Oh, I see
All
the
right.
TV went to sleep behind us.
I guess
us.
We've been going too long. Guess it's time to
wrap it up.
Wrap it up and let you guys go.
There we go.
And
I'm
going to
just
let
get
John
them all the way
yeah, exactly.
all the way up my arm
awesome.
Here. It's going to be awesome.
Thank you guys so much for joining us each and every week. We appreciate it.
We do indeed, and stay with us during the week by following along on Google Plus. She's google.com/+ Callie Lewis. She's also on Twitter at twitter.com/ Callie Lewis.
And he's twitter.com/JohnPose and on Google, google.com/John P/+ John P. I always
There's
forget the
too
plus.
Much. It's right there, baby. So you guys stick with us and we'll see you next week.
Bye, Bye. Guys.
Ah, so now I got to learn nice. How to set my watch here. Kasai. You know what? This is pretty cool. And I like the fact it actually has, do you see, it has the bands.
Yeah.
But do you see there's a leather piece underneath
I
the
do.
Band?
I do see that.
That makes it really comfortable.
Yeah.
And it's sitting nicely on my wrist.
Nice. Good. It's pretty geeky. That's pretty cool.
It is pretty geeky. Which
Sorry, Jenny, I don't have time, unfortunately, to join you guys on the After Live show. But you guys enjoy yourselves.
This is called the Rorschach. I had forgotten.
Rorschach.
It's the Rorschach. Like those,
nice.
Like those.
It's mirrored.
Yes, it's like the Rorschach test that you give crazy people, like my dad, yeah. when you're trying to determine
it's
if
like
they're...
A bat. What time is it? It's like a bat.
I'm going to break my... Tommy, no eating on camera.
Tommy
rule.
G's asking which watch face am I using for my Pebble. So you want
what
to zoom
this?
In on that one for him?
Oh, hang on. I'm getting that thing.
Okay. You should try some of these cake balls.
Zoom in on the watch face there. This is called, what's it called?
How do you know?
It's called Glance, I think. Hang on.
Like
Oh,
he said, yeah, it's an app you put on?
Yeah, it's an app. Yeah, it's called Glance. So what, and it can be configured to do all kinds of different things. I don't know. Oh, you can't really, let me see. How do we get to where you can, it's kind of, okay, you can see kind of at the top. It's got the time, and it's got the date, and it's got a little thing that says it's sunny. It's a little symbol for the weather. It's sunny, it's clear, and 40 degrees outside. And it shows you how many SMSs, how many phone calls, and how many unread emails.
Wow.
766. No, I'm sorry, 1,766 unread emails.
Nice.
Yeah, I think you can watch Netflix, and it picks up Hulu. Just go to netflix.com/...
Look at that.
Geekbeat. Is that, what is that?
I'm not sure. I can't tell.
It's got nuts in it. I'll tell you what it is.
Caramel? Is it the sea salt caramel?
Yeah, it must be. Caramel cake blended with cream cheese icing and sea salt dipped in dark chocolate. No, that's not it.
Do you know which
it.
Ones you got?
That's not it.
Yeah, it says wedding cake, birthday cake, and brownie.
Italian cream cake
wedding
baked
cake?
With coconut and pecans. That's wedding cake. Because there's pecans in there.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
I see
yeah.
Them.
So this is wedding cake, and then this is like, what were the other options?
Birthday cake.
And
brownie.
And brownie.
Birthday
oh, the
cake
brownie would
is
be this one.
French vanilla cake mixed with cream cheese icing, dipped in white chocolate, drizzled with milk chocolate. That mm-hmm. is that one. And the other was what?
Brownie.
Brownie, milk chocolate cake blended with rich chocolate icing and pecan chips and coated in milk chocolate. Birthday cake's the only one I would eat because I don't like pecans.
You don't notice the pecans.
I'm allergic to pecans, deathly. I would go straight to the hospital.
Oh, well, yeah, that'd be a good reason.
You like almonds?
No,
or
really.
Just
Ben said, coconuts, I'm out. Did we do the check-in?
They're awesome, thank you.
Bobbage, we did the check-in like an hour ago or something. I'll try one of these.
Here.
And then
these are brownie.
The sway balls.
Let me tell you if these how these
brownie,
stack up to
Ad
cake, Holly Pose's
cake. Those are the
cake
descriptions.
Balls. Hmm.
Which one did you choose? The birthday cake?
Birthday cake.
Wow, that icing is cool.
It's delicious.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, come on. Okay.
It's sweet and sticky and soft and sweet.
Nice. Bruce.
But it is not as good as Holly's. This is a cream cheese icing. Yours is not cream cheese. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of the cream cheese icing. Although this is the best cream cheese icing I've ever had.
Try one.
Here, you can have one.
When you do cake balls, though, Tilda showed me it's best to use cream cheese.
Thank you, Bruce. Mm. That is a really cute card. Look at that. They asked me to open it.
Everybody say hi to at Holly Pose.
Yes. Oh, we're just the main camera.
Yes, I am a little taller than Holly, so you don't even have to say anything about it.
You're like half a person.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a height difference. That's okay.
To be fair, she married him before he started growing so tall.
Right.
He was the run of the litter. That's the weird thing.
Right.
Nice. And bacon is universally loved.
Right.
She towers over her dad.
Ben.
Nice.
Bacon is universally loved.
Just
like
just
you.
Just like
aww.
You. How sweet.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm digging this watch, but I'm going to have
yeah?
to read the instructions on how
so
to...
It's like always a Rorschach
yeah.
pattern, basically?
Yeah.
Wow.
And so, like...
So it's 2006?
No.
No.
It's actually 644.
Right. Or
it's
if you just look at this half, you'll know.
Yeah, basically, you have to look at half, and you have to, you know, it's 644.
Thank you, Rick.
But really, it's 444, 445. So I need to figure out the time zone thing so I can back it up by a couple hours.
It reminds me of that one that we got a couple
Chris.
Of years ago that we had like the little flip grid of the jewels that flipped all the time. That was really
cool. Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Yeah, really cool.
That's pretty cool.
How'd you come across Kasai?
They sent Callie an email and then she sent it.
Yeah, just
to me, and we
to
chatted
you
with
figure
them.
Out.
Let me see the band.
yeah, check this out. You see, it's connected here and here, but you see how it has that piece that goes that's on the inside?
Yeah.
It is honestly, that has got to be the most comfortable watch band I have ever had on my wrist.
That's cool. Now you're not gonna get that sweaty spot on the dial.
Oh wow.
I think you need to go get that to look at. You got this throat that's protruding through. Holy cow. It's a calcium deposit or something.
I mean, the whole place here smells like bacon.
Yeah, it does.
Holy cow.
Maple bacon. I mean, it really smells like bacon.
That is great. It's like pancakes. Oh my gosh, that's what it is. It's pancakes and coffee.
Ooh.
How to read
it
the time.
It smells like IHOP.
Oh, by the way.
I want to make a bacon pancakes, actually.
By the way.
We were talking about that in Detroit.
This has three settings for the time.
That was like a decision. That was like a week ago.
I know.
This has easy, medium, and hard settings for the time. So you could set this on hard, where it's like you could barely read the damn time.
Well, you're asking people what time it is.
Yeah, it's like, oh,
I don't know.
Don't you have a watch? Yeah, but I can't read this. I mean, good God. Okay, guys, it is officially Friday. It is the day before Callie's birthday. I am the boss of this place. I'm sending people home. Especially her. No work for you this weekend.
What?
No.
I've got a ton to do.
No work for you this weekend, young lady.
You won't know.
I'll
if
fire
I don't...
your ass.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm the CEO.
Oh. No, you're going to fire me? Yeah. I will happily give up my job.
No, let me think this for a minute. I don't want to be writing a show every day. Okay, I'm sending her home so she can take it easy. Everybody, remember, tell her happy birthday.
No, you don't have to. Thank you guys, but no, don't make a big deal out of it.
Set your tweet deck to tell her happy birthday tomorrow. And do the whole happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday.
No, don't.
So it's like four tweets in a row. Do that.
Thank you guys.
I'm just going to sit back and watch the fun ensue.
All right. And no one noticed that Creepy Kitty wasn't even on set.
But Creepy Kitty did. I bet he's been tweeting the whole time.
All right. Bye, guys.
Have a good weekend. We'll see you guys mañana or whatever.